Hello everyone, welcome to the demo video for my monthly meeting notes template. If you haven't purchased this template, I will leave links in the description box below and in the comment area so you can go ahead and grab your copy. Once you purchase this template, the first tab would be a helpful page that contains my contact information as well as useful links and a step-by-step guide that would help you use this template. This template comes with 5 meeting slots and it's meant to be used if you have weekly meetings, so you may have 4 to 5 meetings per month. However, if this doesn't work for you and you want more meetings, I do have an option for you, which is the 10 meeting template. This template comes with 10 meeting slots, all connected to the dashboard area. For the walkthrough video, I will be using the demo copy of this template. All right, so here we are in the demo copy of the template, and the first tab is the setup tab. And in the setup tab, we have the attendance column, status, and the attendees. The attendance and the status column should not be edited because these specific terms have been built into formulas. However, if you do want to use different names or you want to extend the number of options here, just send me an email and I will be happy to help you with that. This column is where you would add in your attendees. You can add up to 40 participants. To edit this section, all you need to do is double click in the cell, highlight what's already there, delete it, and type in your own. If you are not going to be using all 40 slots, you can delete the extra so that the drop-down list in the meeting tabs are not too long. When you need to use more cells, go ahead and type it in and it will show up automatically in the meeting notes area. Here is the dashboard area, and the dashboard area is meant to show you information related to attendance, date, time, duration of the meeting, and the action items. Here I have 8 meetings listed, but do note that the template you have might have either 5 or 10 meetings. The information here does not have to be edited, as it is filled in automatically as you complete the weekly meeting tabs. To use this tab, all you need to do is go through with completing the tabs related to the individual meetings, and this would be completely filled out for you automatically, including the graphs. Next, we have the meeting tabs. And these tabs are identical. We'll start from the top. We have an area that you can type in the weekly meeting title. Just like the other cells, all you need to do is double click, delete what's there, and type in your own information. You have a little section that you can type in the main objective of the meeting. And then here's the area that you would adjust the date and time. To add a date, double click on the cell and the monthly calendar would show up. Select the date for the meeting. Next, you have to add a start time and an end time. All you need to do to do this is to double click on the contents deleted and add your time. So if the meeting were to start at 8 a.m., I would type 8 a.m. Please note that you do have to type a.m. or p.m. for this to work. So if I were to only type 8, it doesn't work. And you can type in whatever increments of time you want. So if you wanted to type in 8:30, it would be 8:30 a.m. And the end time would be just like the start time. All you need to do is type in the time, and this would be, for example, 9:30 a.m. The duration automatically calculates. If I were to change this to p.m., you would see that it also updates automatically. The next section is where we would type in our participants. If you make any changes in the setup area, such as changing the names completely or changing the spellings of the names, you would have to come here and select the correct name. Click on the new name that we entered in the setup tab. So now that we've done that, that error message disappears. If you don't want this list to be long, this drop-down list, you can delete the number of participants that you are not using in the setup tab area, because I do have it pre-programmed to have 40 participants. But if you don't have that many participants in your meeting, you can go ahead and delete it so that this list is not too long. For the attendance section, all you need to do is click on the drop-down arrow to select present, absent, or excused. All right, so the next section in the meeting tab is the meeting agenda. Here's where you would plan for the meeting by typing up the individual agenda items for the meeting. To edit this content of the cell, all you need to do is double click in the cell, highlight whatever is there, delete it, and add in your own. By the way, if you want to go back to the dashboard area, all you need to do is hover around the back to dashboard, click on that, and it takes you directly to the dashboard area. To go back to the meeting we were working on, we'll go back to week 1. And it takes us back there. Moving on to the bottom area, we have the action items. And this is where you would type up the action items for that meeting. Again, to edit it, all you need to do is to double click on the cell, delete the placeholder text, and add in your own. And for the status, click on the drop-down arrow to select not started, in progress, or completed. And finally, you can type in the name of the person that is responsible for that action item. All right, so the next section is the meeting notes area, and this has been built to accept up to 2 rows of text. So what do I mean by that? So you can go ahead and extend this text, for example, by typing in more content, and you can see that it's able to fit in 2 lines of text. So if you wanted to add in more information into 1 row, you do have the option to do that. Now, like I said before, these meeting notes are identical, so any changes we make in the setup area will affect all of the meetings at the same time. So right here, we do have this invalid messages because we deleted all of the placeholder participants in the setup tab. So if we were to click here, you see that the only names that show up are the only names that we left in the setup tab area. The next thing I want to show you is how to rename this area that says week 1, meeting 2, meeting 3, meeting 4. I already did it for the first one because this originally said meeting number 1. So I'll go ahead and rename this one. In order to rename the tab, all you need to do is click on this little arrow next to the name of the meeting. And then once you do that, you do have the option to duplicate, delete, copy, rename, change color, things like that. So what we're looking for here is to rename. So click on that, type in whatever name you want to call the meeting. So we'll call this week 2. Do note that when you rename this and you go back to the dashboard area, it doesn't automatically change this name. But when you hover around it, you can see the new name listed here, but the actual text here doesn't change. In order to change the text that is listed in the dashboard area, you do have to take the additional step to change the name of the meeting as well. So to do this, hover around it until you see this option with copy link, edit, and remove link. Go ahead and select the middle option, which is to edit the link. When you click on edit link, you see that you do have the option to edit the text. This is all you want to edit because we don't want to remove or change anything in this area. Go ahead and just edit the text box area and type in the name of the meeting. Click enter. And now we have the text that has been changed to match the name of the tab. So that brings me to the end of this video walkthrough. Like I said before, if you do need to reach me, my contact information can be found in the instructions area. And remember, this instructions area does come with a quick step-by-step reference guide that you can quickly reference, as well as a section with frequently asked questions. Once again, if you haven't bought this template, I will leave links in the description box area so you can go ahead and grab your copy. This template does come with the 5 meeting tabs, as well as the option that has been expanded to accommodate 10 meetings. Thank you so much for watching.